Guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. My name is Jerina Kazoye, and if you are new to this YouTube channel, make sure you subscribe and make sure you like this video and make sure you comment in the comment section below so that we can interact. So in today's video, I'm going to be talking about advantages, 10 advantages of studying in India. As you know from my previous video, the last video that I did, I mentioned that I'm currently in India, so I'm doing my studies. I'm a third year pharmacy student. So I'm going to be talking about 10 advantages of studying in India. I've been in India for about 2 years, 2 to 3 years. Yeah, I'm now into my third year in India. So yeah, I've been here for some time, and there are a few things that I've noticed about India and I'd like to share with you guys. Yeah. So my first advantage is that in terms of school, Indians are quite serious. Like a practical example is that there's something called attendance. If you don't attend classes more often, you can't write your exams. Your attendance is supposed to be above 70%. So you have to attend classes. So when it comes to medical courses and engineering courses, they're quite serious. I don't know about other courses, but engineering and medical courses, they're quite serious. Like, they push us, and you know, you have to attend classes, because sis, if you don't attend, you won't write that exam. You have to attend classes. And one thing that I've noticed also, when we are learning, they'll be like, if you haven't understood, you can ask them, like, you can DM them, and they reply, like, they reply if you DM them and whatnot. So they push us a lot, and they're quite serious when it comes to school. My second advantage of studying in India is that when it comes to culture, their culture is diverse. You know, they have different types of holidays. If you did religious education back in high school, you know, we learned about Holi, Diwali, all that. You get to express it here. Their Diwali is like Christmas here. You know, it's like their culture is diverse, different cultures. Holiday is quite amazing. The color is like color festival. Yes, like color festival and whatnot. It's just interesting, and it's nice and interesting. Diwali, it's bright everywhere. There are firecrackers everywhere. It's quite interesting. So that's an advantage. You get to experience something new, like adventure, like something new. Like, okay, this is how they celebrate the Diwali. It's really interesting. Yeah. So my third advantage is that India is quite a beautiful place. There's Goa. Goa is a nice place. I've not been there, but it's a really nice place, and I have to go there before I clap. Before I clap school, yeah, I have to go to Goa. There's Manali, there's Taj Mahal. These are very beautiful places. You can go to Mumbai, which is a very nice city. Although I've not been there, but I'll go. So, my fourth advantage is that India is advanced. It's an advanced country. It's quite developed in terms of different things. Let's talk about, they've got electric trains. You know, it's quite advanced, like, it's a developed country. Like, the fifth advantage of studying in India is that life here is quite affordable. Guys, life in India is affordable. Bread for 10 rupees. 10 rupees. I don't know how much 10 rupees is in Kwacha. You just have to know how to take good care of your money and whatnot. But otherwise, life is Gucci. It's affordable. You can't starve. Yeah. My sixth point is that India, like, the people here are quite friendly. In terms of racism, of course it's there, but it's more of curiosity than racism. Like, people are just curious. They want to touch your hair and whatnot. They're not going to judge you or whatnot, but they're just curious, and they are friendly. You know, they're quite friendly. They see Africans, like, sis, like, when I go to the mall sometimes in my afro and whatnot, I feel like I'm a celebrity, because all eyes on me. Like, all eyes on me, all eyes on me. Some of them want to touch my hair. I'm like, hell no, hell no. But yeah, like, the racism here is not that bad. Of course, there are quite a few Indians who are racist, but it's more of a curiosity thing than a racist thing. Like, people are just curious. They just want to know, like, where are you from? Like, why are you in India? Like, that kind of a thing. Like, they're just mesmerized. They're just astonished. They're just perplexed to see you in India. You know, they're just surprised. Like, okay, yeah, sis is in India. Yes, sis is in India. So my seventh point is food. There's a variety of food. Chili, wah, chicken, tandoori. Oh my God, they're different types of food. The thing is that I haven't really explored when it comes to in terms of food, because I'm quite sensitive, like, in terms of what I eat and whatnot, and I don't like spicy things. But the food is amazing. It's amazing. The food that I've tasted, like, what do you call that? I've forgotten, but the food is nice, yo. It's amazing, like it's nice. So my eighth point is that online shopping here in India, it's quite reliable. This Flipkart, Amazon and etc, the different types of online stores, yeah, and they're quite reliable. For example, if you receive a product and you don't like the quality, you can return it back and they'll give it back your money. Like, here's your money. So they don't scam, it's rather scam. If they scam you, like, you know, you have to also like check it out, like check the app and whatnot, but they're quite reliable, they're affordable, they deliver things on time, they don't take time. I once ordered my phone on Amazon, and you know, I received my phone in just two days, yeah, and I gave them money, it was okay. So they can't scam you and they're quite reliable. If you don't like the product, just take it back, you know, they'll give you back your money. So, but just in general, like, online shopping here, you can trust them, it's quite affordable and it's Gucci. Yeah, you know the drill. You don't have to go out all the time. You can just, yeah, food is, you can order food online, clothes, shoes, everything, like, you find them online, which is a good thing. Yeah, so coming to my ninth point, that Indians are quite welcoming. Indians are welcoming. I remember when I came here in India, that was in 2019, when I was in my first year. I came in India my first year, the school organized a party for us, freshers party, and it was free, we didn't have to pay anything. Also, there was another organization that organized a party for Africans also, so they're quite welcoming. They're welcoming people and they're friendly, to be honest. They welcomed us and the food was amazing, so they're very welcoming. You just feel kind of at home. You don't really feel that thing, like, you feel at home, you know, like, they make you feel at home. Like, yeah, of course, when you come just in a few months, you don't really understand what they say, but as time goes on, you get understanding. They just come, like, they become part of you, like, you know, you can live, it's like we are the same people, yo. Like, especially those Indians that live within my hood, like the my G's. Hey G. My 10th point, this is my last point. Indians are quite creative. Let's talk about interior design. Indians want to decorate things. If you're an Indian, you agree with this. Indians are good at decorating things. Interior design, they're perfect. Like, they know how to decorate their houses. They're quite amazing. It's really nice. You know, interior design, you can get some knowledge on how to decorate your rooms and whatnot. You know the drill. They just know. Like, they know what they're doing. They're decorating just the buildings. Oof, they're good. Yeah. So that's it for this video. If this video was entertaining, if it was good, make sure you give it a big thumbs up and make sure you comment below so that we can interact. And don't forget to subscribe. If you haven't yet subscribed, what are you waiting for? Yo, you better subscribe, you know the drill. So make sure you subscribe and make sure you follow me on my Instagram @JorinaKaze. Bye.